Good morning, everyone. This is Pavani. Today, I would like to take for 8th standard the Earthen Goblet poem. And this poem was written by Harindranath Chattopadhyaya. Okay, the Earthen Goblet poem, and this poem was written by Harindranath Chattopadhyaya. So, first, let us see about the poet. Okay, Harindranath Chattopadhyaya was born on 2nd April 1898 in Hyderabad in a Bengali Hindu Kulin Brahmin family to Agornath Chattopadhyaya and Bharatha Sundari Devi. Okay, he was a multi-talented personality as an Indian English poet, a dramatist, an actor, a musician, and a member of the first Lok Sabha from Vijayawada constituency. He was the younger brother of Sarojini Naidu, the first woman president of Indian National Congress. He is famous for the poems like Noon and The Shaper Shaped. Okay, so now let us see about the poem which he was written. Okay, so the Earthen Goblet. You know what is a goblet? Okay, now see here. O silent goblet, red from head to heel, how do you feel when you were being twirled? Okay, upon the potter's wheel, before the potter gave you to the world. So now what the goblet will do here, now see here, O silent goblet, red from head to heel. So now what here, this is the goblet, okay. Now see here the picture is given as goblet is like a human being and it is shedding the tears, right. So now see here, O silent goblet, red from head to heel, how do you feel? Okay, the poet is asking, O silent goblet, how do you feel from head to heel when you were being twirled? So what is the meaning of twirled here? Turn something round and round. What is the meaning of twirl? Turn something round and round. Now you can see in the picture what the potter is doing. He is giving the shape to the pot. So now what the poet is asking here, O silent goblet, red from head to heel. So once when the goblet was made, okay, when it was made, what they will put in the fire to burn it so that it becomes very strong. So red from head to heel, from top to bottom, it will be under the fire so that it becomes very strong. So how do you feel when you were there? Okay, so when you were being twirled upon the potter's wheel, before the potter gave you to the world, before the potter has given you to the world, how do you feel when the potter was making you on his wheel to give a certain shape? Always, first he will give a shape. If it is not in a proper shape, again he will throw it. Okay, again he will dismantle that one. And again he will try to make another pot. Like that, how many times, okay, how many times it has to die in potter's hand to get a proper shape, Okay, that is only the poet telling us here. So, before the potter gave you to the wheel, how do you feel? Then, I felt a conscious impulse. Now, the goblet is speaking. I felt a conscious impulse in my clay. Conscious impulse means what? What is the meaning of impulse? Sudden desire to do something. Okay. The meaning of impulse is what? Sudden desire to do something. Okay. The meaning of impulse is sudden desire to do something. Okay, the meaning of impulse is what? Sudden desire to do something. So now here, I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away from the great potter's hand and burn so warm. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. So what the goblet is telling here, before the potter gave me a certain shape, he was going on killing me on his potter's wheel. Okay, on the wheel, he was going on killing me. If he doesn't get the proper shape, immediately he'll dismantle it, he'll throw that one, and again he tried to make. In that way, he is killing me many times. To break away from the great potter's hand that burned so warm, I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. So instead of that, I am feeling my present form is only best. What is the present form then? Before the potter gives the shape, what is the present form? Just it is a soil, it is a clay, it is a mud. Okay, that is only best. Who is speaking here? The clay. Okay, the goblet. Once when it is made a goblet, the goblet is speaking that my present form is only best compared to this form. Okay, present means what here? Already it was like that, no? Then now see here. Before that fatal hour that saw me captive on the potter's wheel and cast into his crimson goblet sleep, I used to feel the fragrant friendship of a little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. So before the fatal hour means what? Causing death. Before the potter feels that, okay, this shape, I did not make it proper. Before he dismantles that pot, whatever he made. So what he is feeling, what the, like here, goblet is like a human being. The poet compared the goblet as a human being. Actually, don't speak. But in poet's imagination, it is speaking. Okay. So before that fatal hour means what? Before the causing of death, that saw me captive on the prisoner's wheel. Okay, so I am feeling that I am like a prisoner in the hands of whom? In the hands of Potter. Okay, in the hands of Potter, I am like a prisoner because he was going on giving a different shape. He was going on molding me to form a different shape. So that I am feeling like what? I am feeling terribly like what? Afraid. Why? Because again, if it doesn't get proper shape, again he will dismantle it. Like that, how many times he was being killed by Potter? Many times, right? Yes. So, if at all, if he don't get proper shape, certain shape, he cannot sell in the market and he will not get money. So, for that, he'll be going on killing that goblet many times until it gets a proper shape. Okay. So, now, and cast into his crimson goblet sleep. Crimson means what? Bright red in color. Okay. What is the meaning of crimson here? Bright red in color. Okay. The meaning of crimson is bright red in color. For example, if you see the bricks. Whatever the bricks we use to construct a house. Okay, after once when they made the bricks, they put the fire, they put heap of husk around that and they put the fire so that the bricks become very hard and blackish color somewhat so that it will be very strong. Okay, so in the same manner, once when the pots are made, it will be put in the fire so that it becomes very strong and cast into crimson goblet sleep. I used to feel the fragrant friendship of a little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. Bosom means what? Very close friend. What is the meaning of bosom here? Very close friend. Okay. So the fragrant friendship. Fragrant means what? Fragrance means what? The perfume smell. Okay. The beautiful smell. The good smell we can say. The fragrant friendship. Then here the fragrant friendship is, the poet is comparing the fragrance with the friendship of a little flower. From the flower we get the good smell, right? From the flowers we get the good smell. So the fragrant friendship of a little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. The now see here, in my bosom buried deep means what here? See, for example, when we take the soil, when we dig it, we get the soil. In that we can see all the papers which were on the road. Once when it is drowned inside the soil because of rainfall, what happens when we dig to put a plant or something, when we dig the soil, we can get all different papers or some pebbles or something inside the mud, right? So here, small plants which automatically they have grown, we did not sow the seed, okay? Because of the rainfall, they grew on their own, some plants will be. So when we dig the soil, what happens? We can see the plants, okay? We can see the roots, we can see the small saplings, we can see the small plants and the small plants, whatever the flowers they go. So once when this was digged, from where he will get the mud, he digs and he'll get the mud to make the pots, right? So, once when he brought like that, so in that mud, the roots are there. And also, in that mud, the roots are there, the flowers, petals are there, everything is there. So, when he was making the pot, what happens when he was making the pot? To give a certain shape, these roots were also there in that mud. So when the roots are coming like that, he tries to mold it so that the roots also will go inside the pot. Okay, so that means what is happening? See here, the fragrant friendship of a little flowers whose root was in my bosom buried deep. So they were buried deep. He is not taking out whatever is coming out when he was trying to mold the pot. Then the potter has drawn out the living breath of me. At last he has drawn out. He has given a shape like a living breath of me. And given me a form which is the death of me. He is thinking that he has given a good shape. So if he sell in the market, he is going to get the money. But he has given me, which is in the form of a death. Okay. Because many times it was being killed by him on the potter. On the potter's wheel. Okay. So my past unshapely natural state was best. So now present it was made into a goblet because of the potter, But now what the goblet is feeling? My past unshaped was best, which is not having any shape. Okay, the soil which doesn't have any shape, that time only it was best. He has given me a shape and he is giving this to other people to get money, to fetch money. But here I am feeling that my past form is best, which is unshaped, okay, which is not the, which is the natural state, which doesn't have any shape, with just one flower flaming through my breast. So with one flower flaming through my breast means what happens? So now see here, this is the part, okay. See, now the goblet is crying and telling to us, okay, the poet is imagination. In poet's imagination, the goblet is a human being, okay, the goblet is a human being. So this goblet, where you can see this, have you seen any time? So in the movies, we can see kings, they will carry, no, they'll carry which is made with wood or which is made with mud, okay, either it is made of wood or mud. They spit in that, or else they can use if you go to some pilgrimage center, they put this in this, they put the holy water, so that before stepping into that, they touch the holy water, they put on their forehead and they get into the temple, or else they go to even if we go to church also, or else mask, I don't know, but this they will use it, okay. In king's palace we can see, and in pilgrimage centers we can see, okay, the holy water will be placed in that. So now see here, this was the poet which was written by Harindranath Chattopadhyay, and he was comparing like what the goblet as a human being, and how the if the goblet is a human being, how it feels when it was being twirled many times on the potter's wheel. So when it was being many times twirled means what? Turning round and round. So that means it was dying many times in potter's hand. So how it feels, he wants to tell as if he is a human being, what he is going to say. So that is only about the poem, The Earthen Goblet. And this was written by Harindranath Chattopadhyay. In this, he beautifully explained about if a goblet is a human being, how it expresses its feeling. Okay. So, I hope everyone have understood. To get a clear understanding, once or twice you read the poem so that you will get a clear understanding. So, thank you everyone.